Hi friends, welcome to our YouTube channel. Today we are going to talk about few exercises that you can do anywhere. Here are the guidelines and tips of each exercise that is beneficial for your fitness and strength. If you find this video helpful, please like and subscribe to our channel. Hit the bell icon to get regular updates. Now let's begin your journey with these exercises shown in the video. So let's begin with push-ups. Push-up is best for warming up your body. Begin in a plank position with your arms straight. Your shoulders should be over your wrists and your body should form a straight line from head to toe. Keep your core engaged and don't let your hips sag. Next, slowly bend your elbows and lower your chest towards the floor. Then press upwards back to plank position. Complete 3 sets of 8 to 10 push-ups. If you are struggling before the end of your second set, make note of how many push-ups you have completed with solid form. Then drop to your knees or do another modification. Next is mountain climbers. It is a total body workout. Get into a plank position on the hands and toes. Your hands should be about shoulder width apart, back flat, abs engaged and head in alignment. From this position, pull the right knee into your chest as far as you can. Now switch and bring the other knee in. Your shoulders, arms and chest work to stabilize your upper body while your core works to stabilize the rest of your body. Your quads get an incredible workout as the prime mover. Number 3 is alternating lunges. Stand upright, keep your feet hip width apart and place your hands on your hips. Lunge forward with the right leg, then bend both knees and lower your hips until both knees are bent at 90 degrees. Rise and pull back the right leg to starting position. Lunge forward with the left leg and keep alternating legs after each repetition. Keep the torso upright all the time and make sure the front knee doesn't extend past the toes when you lunge forward. You can also put your hand straight like in the video. Lunges tones the thighs, calves, butt and core. Up next is squats, the body weight squat. Stand with feet a little wider than shoulder width apart, hips stacked over knees and knees over ankles. Roll the shoulders back and down away from the ears. Allowing the back to round will cause unnecessary stress on the lower back. It's important to maintain a neutral spine throughout the movement. Extend arms out straight so they are parallel with the ground, palms facing down. If it's more comfortable, pull elbows down to the body, palms facing each other and thumbs pointing up. Initiate the movement by inhaling and unlocking the hips, slightly bringing them back. Keep sending hips backward as the knees begin to bend. The best squats are the deepest ones your mobility allows. Optimal squat depth would be your hips sinking below the knees. You can do full squat as well as half squats. So the next one is standard planks. Plant the hands directly under the shoulders, slightly wider than shoulder width apart, like you are about to do a push-up. Ground the toes into the floor and squeeze the butts to stabilize the body. Neutralize the neck and spine by looking at a spot on the floor about a foot beyond the hands. Hold the position for 20 seconds. As you get more comfortable with the move, hold your plank for as long as possible without compromising form or breath. Planking is a simple but effective body weight exercise. Holding the body stiff as a board develops strength primarily in the core, the muscles that connect the upper and lower body as well as the shoulder. There are variations for the side plank. Let's start with forearm plank. This variation, also one of the most common ways to perform a plank, is slightly easier than holding the body up with just the hands. Place the forearms on the ground with the elbows aligned below the shoulders and arms parallel to the body at about shoulder width distance. If flat palms bother your wrist, clasp your hands together.